In this screencast, we're going to take a look at how to use bookmarks in IntelliJ IDEA. So you're working on a feature or bug fix, and you see some parts of the code that you want to come back to later. You could use recent files, but you have to remember where you saw this code. This is where bookmarks come in handy. Let's take a look. For example, we're navigating a codebase and see something interesting that we want to look at later. We can bookmark this line by pressing F3 on Mac or F11 on Windows and Linux. This shortcut creates an anonymous line bookmark marked with a bookmark icon. If we don't remember the shortcut, we can right-click the gutter next to the line of code that we want to bookmark and select Add Bookmark. We can also bookmark files, packages, folders, and modules. Let's open the Project Tool window, Command-N1 on Mac, or Alt-N1 on Windows and Linux, and add an anonymous bookmark. We can use the shortcut F3 on Mac or F11 on Windows and Linux, or we can right-click the item we want to bookmark and select Bookmarks, Add Bookmark. Anonymous bookmarks don't have an identifier, and we can create as many as we like. We can also create bookmarks that are assigned a digit or letter. To add a mnemonic line bookmark, press Option F3 on Mac or Control F11 on Windows and Linux, and press the digit or letter to use as an identifier for this bookmark. Again, we can also right-click the gutter next to the line of code that we want to bookmark and select Add Mnemonic Bookmark. Optionally, we can provide a description for the new bookmark. We can double-click the digit or letter we want to assign. Lines marked with mnemonic bookmarks have the corresponding digit or letter icon in a frame. If the selected mnemonic is already used, the IDE will ask you whether you want to overwrite an existing bookmark with a new one. When we select the Don't Ask Again option, the IDE will silently overwrite mnemonics. Now that we created all of these bookmarks, how do we go back there? There are several options. To see all line bookmarks that we have in the code, we can open the Bookmarks pop-up by pressing Command F3 on Mac or Shift F11 on Windows and Linux. We can also open it in the main menu by going to Edit, Bookmarks, Show Line Bookmarks. Notice that this list does not contain any project items like files or classes that we've bookmarked. We can select the bookmark we want to navigate to, either with the up and down arrows and pressing Return on Mac or Enter on Windows and Linux, or by double-clicking it. For mnemonic bookmarks, we can select the corresponding digit or letter. To jump straight to a mnemonic bookmark, hold Control on Mac or Windows and Linux, and press the mnemonic digit or letter on the keyboard. We can't navigate directly to anonymous bookmarks, but we can assign a mnemonic to an existing anonymous bookmark, either by using the shortcut or by clicking the bookmark in the gutter and selecting Assign Mnemonic. This works in the Bookmarks pop-up too. To see all our bookmarks, we can open the Bookmarks tool window by pressing Command 2 on Mac or Alt and 2 on Windows and Linux, or by selecting View, Tool Windows, Bookmarks from the main menu. IntelliJ IDEA adds your bookmarks to the predefined list in the Bookmarks tool window that's created automatically and has the same name as the project. In this example, multiple bookmarks in the same file are grouped together. We can also turn that off in the Options menu. As we can see, there are several other options as well. We won't dive into all of them, but be aware there are more options you can configure to your liking. One option we do want to show you here is that you can create more lists. We can add a new list using the shortcut Command N on Mac or Alt and Insert on Windows and Linux, or by clicking the Create Bookmark List button. We can add a name for the new list. If there are multiple lists and we create a new bookmark, we can select which list to add it to in the Add Bookmark pop-up. We can also select the list to use as default by checking the option Use as Default List. In the Bookmarks tool window, we can move bookmarks to another list by dragging them to the other list. And we can sort bookmarks by selecting a bookmark and using Move Down, Option Command Arrow Down on Mac, or Control Alt Arrow Down on Windows and Linux, or Move Up, Option Command Arrow Up on Mac, or Control Alt Arrow Up on Windows and Linux. Fun fact! the Bookmarks tool window also shows any breakpoints. Breakpoints are automatically added to the list once you place them in your code. Finally, we can also bookmark editor tabs. Click the three dots to the right of the tabs and select Bookmark Open Tabs. We can enter a name for this list in the Create Bookmark List pop-up. As we've seen, bookmarks allow us to save certain interesting locations in the codebase, so we can easily go back to them later. Thanks for watching.